Hello.
Hello, Moto.
Like a cockatiel. This is what an Airbnb-er left us. They left behind a shit ton of booze and liquor, and yay. Yay for us. We can reap the rewards of that.
I'm out of weed, and all I have left is hash
from when I still trimmed weed. I don't do that no more. This is, this is the last of my stash. I love MIA, man. Blah. I love MIA, man. I saw this documentary that she did on her shit, and it's good. Reminds me of me. I mean, in a way. I don't know. Also inspiring. Alright. She just has fun. She follows the dopamine. I also follow the dopamine. Fuck you. I should be out post-mating it right now, but I need some self-love time. I need to, do something for me. And this is it. It's what I do for me. This and video games and writing is about the only fucking things that I do for myself anymore. Everything else is work. No. Stop it. Tonight I'm all stressed out because my fucking stepsister is becoming an alcoholic, if not just is one, and it's very confusing because her mom was an alcoholic and her mom finally got over that shit. It took fucking forever. And now she's on the fucking... It's just really fucking hard to watch her chug a fucking bottle of liquor, you know? I asked my dad what he thought about it, but I probably overstepped my fucking bounds because I talked about it. And it's none of my goddamn business! But apparently they're talking to her now, and I feel just so shitty because I feel like I betrayed her trust, but it's getting bad. I'm concerned. Really bizarre watching her in my I interviewed her for this documentary I'm doing about my fucked up life. She's talking about how she hated watching her stepmom be an alcoholic and, you know, it hurt her feelings and all this shit.
When I was getting ready to graduate and everything, mom got stressed and she started drinking again. So then she got obnoxious, but I just had to think in the back of my head, I'm leaving in a month. I can't fight with my mom because then I'm going to be gone and I'm going to wish I didn't fight with her, so I just dealt with it.
Now she didn't break the fucking cycle. It's just so bizarre to me that people don't break the cycle. Ooh, I love it so much. puppy girl. You're a dog that's a girl. She's a dog that's a girl. She's so sweet. Apparently this app blurs the background, which is kind of cool, but you can't really see my dog very well in that case.
Ooh, I love it so much, I'm doing things I wouldn't normally do.
Oh, this is a local band, by the way. I like them.
I like them a lot.
They were opening for another band that we liked, and I was like, God damn, this is like my jam, and I feel like this is not a lot of people's jams, but it is definitely my jam. So all of these songs are songs that I discovered when I was 33 and 34 years old. I'm about to be 35 this coming April 2nd. And thus begins a new playlist. Seb DeLisa, I don't even know if I'm saying her fucking name right, but so good. I love her shit. I wonder if she has new stuff out.
Help me in and out. I won't even hear one time. It's passing by. And in the night, in front of my judgmental eye, I am flesh. Bones. I am skin. I am human. Nothing more than human. I am sweat. Nothing more than human.
Need to make me a fucking music video in slow-mo. No one's fucking music is slow-mo worthy, though.
All about balance. Find some time just for me. Also work on goals that we need.
I have a rap EP. Like I said earlier, I followed the dopamine and I just got a hair up my ass to like rap for a while. I don't know. Poet isn't such a huge leap to fucking rapper, you know what I mean? I'll play you a couple clips of my rap shit. So it started with Not My Day.
Like a party will suddenly give you some kind of fame. Smoking through bars is a coffin shame. You butchering your words and you choking your dope. You're supposed to guide others to ideas of hope, not things and stuff. If you cared enough, you would pop the clutch, pedal metal and such. Speedily speak free to me the ways that you bleed across this fucked country.
Which ended up playing on, like, Canadian radio, and it was, like, in the top charts or something. I don't know if I could find a fucking photo of that. And then I was sitting at work, and then I was thinking, you know what would make a really good trap fucking sample?
Spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down.
And I was like, I'm gonna try and do a trap beat to fucking Mary Poppins.
The medicine go down, 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 down.
And so then we did a music video for that for my birthday. That's all I fucking wanted. For my birthday, I wanted to do a goddamn music video. This is how much I love doing music videos.
Why
And then I went like down the conspiracy theory tunnel with Ronald Bernard and all of his shit that he was talking about. So then I ended up writing a fucking song about him.
Ha. Fuck you all. I wanted to destroy, so I needed a lot of money.
Now he's top gun, working with professionals, banking international, climbing the lace, upwards and diagonal. He couldn't discuss this move, cash for the government and secret services. Then came the terrorists and even churches, funding war merchants, he never felt burdened.
This is about a very evil dark force who really enjoy to destroy all life on this planet.
And then I ended up reworking one of my old poems about my abusive ex and my shitty fucking abusive mother and my depression and all that kind of crap. And I love that one. I'm so in love with it, but...
See, I had no one to lean on.
I love that I look all like cracked out and deathly in the album cover too. I look all emaciated and half dead. I don't know. I like it. It was a lot of fun for the time being, but I'm like thoroughly over it. It was just a phase. I just wanted to play. And that's on ADD. I also did like other random music. I just had like a huge music phase. I totally fucking threw away film. I had a fucking meltdown because like I almost made making real estate videos a fucking business and I just melted under the pressure. I didn't want to do it. It's not something I wanted to do. But I didn't like touch filming for like a year or something. So instead I made like fucking random shit. Fucking depressed and making shit like but then also like super happy shit, you know, but it was all just super music focused for a while.
Everybody dies, it's true. Him and her and you kids beware when they attack. Dress ugly if you are black.
We
now it's like very little of anything. I like barely film shit. I barely write. I barely make music. You know what's fun? It's like all these... I'm like a professional commenter. I can't make any videos go viral, but my comments go viral on like TikTok and Facebook or whatever, having all these kind of like big name people liking my shit. Janet Jackson hearted one of my comments. She's my number one like OT favorite, so I freaked the fuck out. Fucking singer of Incubus liked one of my comments. Azam Ali, like the guitarist from Cold, added me. It was crazy. I should probably take that as a sign or something and try to do something else where I'm commenting on the content. Should do like Riff Trax or MST3K. I tried to do that once before with my sister. It was actually pretty fucking funny. Maybe I should redo that again. Or we watched One Missed Call and it was just... That movie is so bad. Oh, bad bitch. Alright, y'all. I think I'm gonna get the fuck out of here. I think I talked a lot today. I think I got a little too intimate today. So... ASMR. I really fucking hate ASMR. Hey y'all, for real though, like if you could find me some ASMR that is like some old grandma ladies being like, ay, que lindo, que, oh, que bonita, que bonita, que linda. That is the ASMR I need. I need some grandmas giving compliments and soothing before bedtime. I need to hear it. It makes me so happy when I'm out in public and I hear people say my name in fucking Spanish. Cassandra. I'm like... Two beers and a ball of hash deep. So, yeah. Hopefully this isn't too loud because I realize that I've just been holding the fucking microphone this whole time. All right. I'm gonna go to sleep now. I'm just kidding. I actually have to go to work now. I'm gonna go deliver your food around Denver.